In this tutorial, we start modeling a house. You'll learn how to make the basic shape, add windows, door, and doorstep. In our last tutorial, we've been working with moving, rotating, and scaling objects. Today we're going to have a look into edit mode. So what is edit mode? Well, we've moved, rotated, and scaled the object, but you can also manipulate the object inside. So what we're going to do is select with the left mouse button the cube. And here on the top left, you can choose for edit mode. So if I use my scroller to zoom in a little bit, you see you can now manipulate the inside of the object. So what you see here are several planes, the top, the left, and the front plane. And here you see these orange dots. Well, these orange dots are called vertices, or a vertex. And a vertex is connected via an edge. That's, for example, this line here, they're all edges. And these planes are called faces. And not by coincidence, here on the top left, you see three different selection methods. So this is now the vertex mode. So when I'm in vertex select and I click with my left mouse button on these corners, you see they will lit up. And if I hold down shift, I can select multiple of them. If you go to the edge mode, you can select the edges. So I can now not select the corner here, but I can select the edge of these planes. The third option is face select. When I use face select, I can select the complete planes of this cube. There are shortcuts for this, so you don't have to move over here and select these. This one is selected by the one. So if I press the one on my keyboard, then I'm in vertex mode. If I press the two on my keyboard, then I'm in edge select mode. And if I press the three on my keyboard, I'm in face select mode. And this is the 1, 2, 3 above the Q, the W, and the E, if you use a QWERTY keyboard, but not the right side, which we've used to change the views. We can switch between edit and object mode by using the tab key. So I'm pressing tab to leave the edit mode. You can see on the top left that I'm now back in object mode. Well, if I press the numeric 1, so I'm going to look at the front. You see here this red line, and you see my cube is below that red line, so it's not on 0. So what I'm going to do is press G for move, and I hold down Control, and then I can move it exactly on that red line. Remember from the last lesson that you can use snapping on the grid with Control. So I confirm with my left mouse button, and now I press the numeric 0 for camera view. You can also view it here with viewpoint camera, or you can press here on the camera. And as you can see, the cube is outside the camera. So what I'm going to do here on the top right, I select the camera, press G to move, the Z to lock the Z axis, and move the camera a little bit up. So this cube is perfectly aligned with the camera. I'm leaving some space on the top since we're going to build a house and we need some room for the roof. You can confirm your movement with your left mouse button. So I'm going to select my cube again and I'm going back to my normal 3D view. So here I'm in the front orthographic view, but I'm holding down my middle mouse button and dragging a bit like this. So now I want to switch to the edit mode since we're going to make the first step of the roof. So I'm pressing the tab key and make sure you are in face select mode. Otherwise, press the 3 on your keyboard and you can select it. The faces. So I'm selecting here the top face. And now I'm going to show you a new operation. And this operation is called extruding. Extruding extrudes the face you've selected. And the short key for extrude is the E. So I press the E key and you see it's immediately locked to the Z axis. You can also say X and Y, but for us, the Z is perfectly fine. So now when I'm using CTRL, you see it will snap over here, and I've extruded the cube. So I confirm with my left mouse button. And now you see that we have the basic of our roof. Now we want to make it more triangular. So here we see the red line is the x-axis. You see it here on the top right. So I'm going to press S for scale, but now I'm making a pyramid shape, and that's not what I want. So I press the X key, and now you see I'm basically making the roof as I want for my house. So if I hold down CTRL, you see you can snap it and you can choose how you want to make the roof. You can also go too far, as you can see over here. So now I'm moving too far over each other. And I like to have some space. I don't want to have an exact pointy roof, so like this. And I confirm with my left mouse button. In order to make the windows and the door and the doorstep, we're going to cut through our object. And this operator is called loop cut. So the short key for that is CTRL R. So when I press CTRL R in my object, you see these yellow lines. And the yellow line indicates where I'm going to cut my object. So you now see a single cut, but I can also use multiple by scrolling. So if I use my scroll wheel, you see then I can say how many cuts I need. Well, for this tutorial, I need 4 of them in the front, like this. So I confirm with my left mouse button. After confirming, you see that you can also move around in the face to see where you want to make your cut. But I want to make it exactly in the middle. In order to reset the movement I'm just doing is the right mouse button. When I click on it, you see it jumps back to the correct position where it's all symmetrical. So I confirm with my left mouse button. So now we want to do the same, but now horizontally. So I press CTRL R again, and we want to cut this plane. So I'm clicking with my left, I'm scrolling up. So let me see how much we need. We need 2 cuts. So I'm clicking with my left mouse button, but I want to make it a little bit higher. I need a larger door and smaller windows, like this. So I confirm with my left mouse button. And then we also have the doorstep. So what I'm going to do is press CTRL R again, click with my left mouse button and make it on the lower side, like this, and confirm with my left mouse button. Now that we're done cutting with the object, it's time to create the windows, the door, and the doorstep. So what we need is face select. And face select was the number 3 on your keyboard, and now you can select the faces. I'm holding down shift to select multiple faces, so these are the 2 windows, and I'm also selecting the door. Now we press E to extrude, and instead of moving forward, you can also move them inward. And when I hold down CTRL, you see these big gaps. So CTRL is snapping a little bit too much, so I'm going to do this on the eye. So I think this is quite nice. So I press with my left mouse button to confirm. Now we only need the doorstep. So I'm selecting here the doorstep, press E to extrude and move it a little bit forward. So now the basic shape of our house is finished. So this is a perfect moment to save our scene. So we're going to File, choose Save As, and I'm going to call it not Untitled, but House Part 1. And I press Save As. And when I do, you see here on the top, House Part 1.blend, so you know it's saved. And this concludes the first part of our house tutorial. You've learned how to switch between object and edit mode. You've also learned how to use the extrude operator. And you also learned to work with a loop cut to create the windows, the door, and the doorstep. You've also learned how to save your scene. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. And in the description of the video, you find more information about this episode and also links to other tutorials. I see you in the next episode.